Hello everyone! Today we will be covering how to use the Materials palette in FormIt. For this we will use the Create Primitives Cube or Alt-B to demonstrate. Let's begin by selecting the Materials palette from the palette toolbar. And currently we don't have any materials in our sketch, so let's drop down the In Sketch options and select Material Samples. Here there are folders with corresponding materials inside. If we open the brick and block folder, a paintbrush cursor appears and any material that we select will be added to our InSketch materials. So when we select one, we are taken back to our InSketch options, and as you can see, it has been added to the model materials. We are also automatically inside of the paint tool, so if we hover over our cube, we can click the faces we want to paint with this material. If our cube is grouped and we want to paint it without editing the group, the entire group will be painted this material. So let's add a few more samples of different categories, drop down the menu to select material samples, open a folder and select an item. This will bring you back to the materials in the sketch, so when you repeat the process you can use the navigate up button to get back to the main folders. At the top of the materials palette you can create a new material, delete a material by selecting the material and pressing this button. You can pick a face to paint with its material, which will activate the eyedropper for you to soak up a material in the canvas, which then turns to the paintbrush with that material activated. You can link a materials directory folder, which can contain image files of JPEGs and PNGs, or a FormIt file AXM, and FormIt materials will automatically be created based on the images and or materials of the FormIt file. Press the refresh button to refresh the link. You can also delete all unused materials if you want to clean up your model. Materials that display with halftone gray titles are not currently in this model and will change to blue once you have used them. Notice how in the materials sample and in sketch you have this filter entry. If we type in glass, only the materials with glass in the name will appear. To clear this filter, press the X button. Once your material is painted on a face, you can adjust its orientation, location, and scale on the face by selecting the face, right-clicking to the context menu, and selecting the Adjust Material Placement, or the keyboard shortcut MP. Once in this tool, you are given a protractor widget and a square widget. The protractor will allow you to rotate the material using the arc blue grip and typing in the angle. The square will allow you to scale the material. The top arrow and side arrow will scale in the single direction, and the corner arrow scales proportionally. Notice how you can also type in the dimension or the percent proportion. You can drag the center grip to move the placement of the material, and if you want to start over, just paint the material on the face again from the materials palette. And that's it for FormIt Materials Palette. Be sure to check out more videos on the FormIt YouTube channel.